Look, I muted it again. I'm gonna get this down. Hi, it's Katie. Welcome back if you're joining us. joining me. That makes way more sense. Today we are going to continue on our Star Wars Baby Yoda army journey. But I'm actually gonna put one together today, so yay! I am almost done making all of the parts. I've got all the arms, I've got a large majority of ears. I think I've got one more set of ears to do, maybe two, and then a couple more scarves. And then it's moving on. Yay! So, that's what we're gonna do. We're also gonna do a simple little bookmark today, because it works up quick, and it's pretty, and it's fun, and useful. And it's something different. So, as always, I can't do the same thing the whole time. So if you catch the stream and want to chat, feel free to hit me up. I have yet to have anybody come out and chat with me, so I'd love to try. So yeah, that's it. So, let me go and pull this up real quick. If you're on Facebook, I do have a Facebook page for my crochet projects. It's called The Little G, letter G, dash, the letter N, the letter E. That is my quote-unquote company name, The Little Genie. It is based off of my three children's names. I will not say them, but that's what it's based off of. So, I'm just putting a little post up there real quick, because I forgot to do that before I started. My one scarf to dude. We're gonna give him. I want to see some progress of my own here. So I think this guy needs a finished friend, at least. So that's what we're gonna do today, is at least assemble this one. Maybe crochet one more scarf part of it, and then move on to that thing that I was going to make the bookmark. So here we go. So let's start off with getting rid of the scarf, because it's hard to put it on with it on. Or put it on. Attach these with it on. Boy, words are going to be fun today. Alright, so these little arms are going to get a little bit of stuffing. That might actually be too much. Let's start with a little less. Just use the back of my hook here. When you start tearing off little parts of this, of the stuffing, the fibers start getting everywhere. There's that one. For that one. Oh, that just came right back out. So I have ripped my nail on my index finger a little bit. Doubt you can see that. But if you can, it's right on the side. But it goes across my cuticle, nail bed, and therefore I can't just rip it off. So it's been a slow process, but it catches in everything. Every time I put my hair back, anytime I mess it with yarn, it gets caught. Because, of course, it's on this side and not the underside. It just gets caught in everything. It's really annoying. Okay. Let's put this and give him some arms. We're just going to put them on either side, and we are going to stitch through and across each of these stitches on the top of the arm in a very simple straight stitch. Oh, but this little Yoda will be so happy to have an arm. And then two. Won't know what to do with himself. Go play some football or something. So I am thinking that I might be adding a stream on Fridays. There we go. That's what my problem was. I need to go under first. I mentioned when I first started a couple weeks ago that I thoroughly enjoy making paper crafts. If you could see back here, I started one on Friday. We have a scrapbook group here at my church, and while I don't scrapbook, I do use that time to paper craft. And it is a craft I have been wanting to do for quite some time, but it is called the Balsam Manor House. It is a cut pattern, cut file that I got off of svgcuts.com. Love her stuff. Mary does an awesome job with that. But I cut out the pieces that are finished over here. I cut out like over a year ago. And then, you know, life. So I started assembling it this past Friday at that crop night, and now I'm just super excited. It's giant. But now I really want to get on it, and I've got some paper crafting projects that I've got coming up anyway. So I was thinking maybe I might add a stream cycle to this and do paper crafting on Fridays. So that could be fun. If that is of any interest to anyone who might come across this, send me a message. Let me know. That would interest you at all. The builds are really cool. If you have any experience with paper crafting and you've seen anything from SVG Cuts, you would know. It's one of my favorite things to do. I have, going off screen for a second. Well, maybe not, that's a wide screen. I love 3D builds. This is one of the things I built a year or two ago. It is a truck, I think. It is all paper. Every bit of it is paper, with the exception of the brads underneath. But yeah, it's just a 3D truck. It's fun. It's kind of, with the way that it's designed, it kind of has a suspension. It's hard to tell when it's sitting up like this, but it's fun to push down on it. but that's one of the things I've done, amongst lots of other things. I made a whole bunch of churches one year. A couple of them with alternating decorations for the seasons. So they're just, it's a lot of fun to do. And I'd love to be able to spend more time on it and get back into it a bit. So, all right, that's arm number one. Time to arm number two. Now, I went a little low on that first one, so I'm going to have to go low on this one, too. Go back a stitch, though. Coworkers in the office next to me making lots of noise. Wonder what she's up to. It's her storage unit, so she's going through something, trying to find something or other. Reorganizing? I'm not really sure. Make sure his arms are nice and secure and that they are not going to go anywhere. Stepping inside, snip that off. And Baby Yoda's got arms. Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo. Now let's give him some ears. How about that? These are a little more tricky to assemble. Not because it's any kind of special stitch or anything, but just you have to, and since I don't use pins, you have to kind of curl them. So if you put them on straight, like that, obviously it's going to do weird things. So you kind of have to curl them in as you sew. To go right about here. Looks good. So one up. How many stitches? One, two, three, four. Four, it looks like. Alright. Going in. Can't really see what I'm doing now, can you? I adjusted it higher, and now I need to adjust it lower. Alright. So I'm just holding that curl in, and we're gonna go through that first stitch. Once you get it about halfway, you don't really have to hold it much anymore. second stitch there. And when you're assembling this, you don't want to go too far in front of the previous stitch that you're sewing into. Otherwise, it's going to start stretching your work that you're doing, and or you're going to have really long stitches that you can see, you know, visually. Of course, because, you know, you see things. Things I say sometimes, I don't understand myself. But they'll be very noticeable. That's what I was going for. So as you do that curl, you kind of want to just see what's right in front of the next stitch as compared to maybe one stitch over that might be easier to get to, but won't be as aesthetically pleasing. Gaining all of your senses, Baby Yoda. Started off being able to see, and now you can touch and feel, and in just a second, once you're secured in there, you'll be able to hear on one side. These stitches through, securing stitches. Sometimes half the battle is just finding where it'll come out the other side without pushing all your stuffing through. Because those fibers can get thick. If you do these kind of stitches, you want to be careful not to pull it too tightly or else it's going to. So here, I'll show you. If I pull tightly back here, you can kind of see that dent in his head now. Right there. So you want to make sure not to do that. And if you do, just kind of stick your needle back in there, force it out. So now, look there. Can't really tell unless you're really looking for it. Alright. Cut him off. And Yoda, get here halfway. You're not going to worry too much about the shape at the moment, so like if it bends over or falls or something like that, not a big deal. Once his scarf gets put on there, that'll take care of that issue for the most part. If you really, really want to make sure it keeps its shape, you can take a steamer to it, just kind of shape it how you want. Let it fully dry. So that's always an option. But I have better things to do in my life than that, so I'm not doing it. Alright, follow this around so that it's even. Going around this insert you into this hole. Try and make you as symmetrical as possible so you don't look funny. Alright, and here we go. On to ear number two. Alright, that's in. We are curling around to this row. And do that like that. I'm just going to hold it. That's how I like it. And again, if you like to use pins, more power to you. To me, that's just more that I have to keep track of. Or they get in my way, because I have tried them, and just not a fan. Every once in a blue moon, I might use them only if it's a particularly difficult assembly. I'm just not having it that day or something, I don't know. But that's about the only time that I would use it, so if I just, it's just not working. With me holding it. For the most part, I usually don't have an issue. It might take me a beat longer than others or so, but I can handle it. And now I am doing the Jurassic World here. My sons love dinosaurs. They are begging to watch all of the Jurassic Park and all the Jurassic World movies. However, they are 8 and almost 6. And Dad and I just don't think that it's, appropriate for that age. Little tiny nightmares, especially for my 8-year-old. He is super sensitive to scary things, and as much as my 6-year-old doesn't want to admit it, he can be as well. So we're just holding off until they're a little older, even though they hate it. We just kind of feel, you know, we're the parents. It's our job to protect them, even in the way that their brains think sometimes. Until they really kind of prove that they're ready for it. And you may disagree with that. That's fine. Won't hurt my feelings if you do. But alas. They're my kids, so we will parent them how we feel about it, how we feel we should. Couple more stitches here, and he will be fully eared up. Corner stitch there. Bring that around. There. to make me feel better. There we go. And now we go to some securing threads and give him a scarf. And that's one more buddy done. Go through his head a little bit. The top of his head, that is. Garbage can ran away from me. Alright. He's got ears! Whee! Now, just kind of fit the scarf over top for the finishing piece. This scarf does not have to be sewn onto it. It just kind of securely snugs against him. As all scarves should. Should be nice and snuggly, but removable. And we have, shake him out, another Baby Yoda! There he is! Baby Yoda 2. This is here's where. There, yeah. Okay. Here's his friend. His ears were made a little differently, so they curl substantially more. They've since learned a new finishing way for him, so these guys stick out a little bit more than this guy does. Yay! But look, they're done! Woohoo! You can tell the difference in the arms that I went one too low. Let's see if I can pull that down just a touch more. Kind of push those arms down. That's a little better. Oh, he's backwards. Yep, arms definitely gotta go up one more. But that's okay. Where's the fun if they are completely stitch for stitch identical? Alright. So there's one more of those done. I'm going to go ahead and make another scarf. And now that I think about it, I forget what pattern is. Pull that up real quick. How many? 30 stitches. 30 and then single. Half single, half. Chain it. Alright. Alright, off we go to do this one. And 30. Straighten that out a little bit so that we can start to the circular push it here. Twist that around. And we're going to I might actually give it a try and not do a slip stitch here and just go ahead and start crocheting. Just to see what that looks like. That's one. That in there. Two. I don't really care for weaving in ends all over the place. So if I can secure them into the project, I will do that. Overweaving. Once again, work smarter, not harder, in my opinion. Pull that through a little bit. Snip that up. Tiny, tiny little piece there. Alright, and we continue our work around. As I've mentioned, I am new to streaming, so I learn more and more each week. And I've been trying to figure out how folks get away with playing music on their channels that I've seen. My husband recently informed me that there are straight up non-copyrighted playlists out there and available. So I'm going to be looking into that just so I can have something playing in the background, because nice to have something other than silence, so. Hopefully, in the next stream, you'll hear some background music that I won't be in trouble for. Twisted my scarf. That would have been a bad look for Baby Yoda here. Alright, so we've made it all the way around, and now we're going to start our double crochet. I did twist it. Hold on. Back off. One sec. Okay, let's see here. I want to bring this in. I don't like how that hangs out down there. I just don't like it. So I'm going to do that. And then, can I do this? Hold on. This is what happens when you play around. You lose where your stitches. Whoopsie. I'm going to bring you into the fold here. Slip stitch on that so that we can bring it up. And then double crochet into this stitch. Now it's kind of at a funny angle because I did what I just did. But I'm gonna get it. There we go. I'm sorry, half double crochet. Even with that slip stitch, it still doesn't really make it flat. I've got to figure out what I can do to change that. So that I'm happy with it. Over these next few scars that I have to make. I'm so close to being out of this yarn. Hopefully I'll finish it. I should. Not the yarn itself, but I'll finish the scarf before I run out of yarn. I just fell right off my hook. Okay. And sometimes my animals get involved in my crocheting. Just had to pull one of their little furs out, little hairs. So let me tell you, animal fur, animal hairs stick to yarn like crazy. I do my very best to never have my yarn somewhere where it like touches the floor or, you know, any place that one of the animals has been. Sometimes it just kind of happens and I don't realize it. And then as I crochet around, get these random animal furs and everything. Unfortunately, no matter how much you clean your house, the animal fur is still everywhere. Alright, one more round of singles, and then one more round of half doubles, and this scarf is complete and ready for our next new friend. We are coming into Thanksgiving break here. So my kids have school today and tomorrow. And then my older two have asynchronous day on Wednesday. If you don't know what that is, good on you, because it's ridiculous. Basically, they have to do schoolwork on their computer all day. I don't quite understand why. Just give them the day off. You're just giving them homework to do on a day, but you have to submit it within the same day to not get counted as absent from school. It's crazy. I am definitely an old school person in that regard, where I don't feel like, unless it's computer class, elementary kids should be using computers to do schoolwork. You even have studies out there showing that pen and paper you learn better with, rather than everything digital. Sure, give them a computer class in elementary school. It works. And when computers first came out, but when they were readily accessible for the home, you know, that was 80s. I was just born mid 80s, and I think we got a computer that we were allowed to play on in the early 90s, so I was like maybe 7 or 8. Maybe a little younger. When we got our first computer in our house, and now it's just a staple. It's like, you're weird if you don't have one. But the problem that I have found, which I do take it upon myself to attempt to teach them, but they don't teach these elementary kids any typing skills, and then they tell my first operator to type answers in a sentence on their computer, and then they're sitting there going, but it's really slow because they don't even know where the letters are. So it's like, it's like watching my dad try and type. It's crazy. So, fully feel, I'm just going to unravel this because it just keeps getting stuck. Really feel like if you're going to make elementary students, do things on their computer, you need to teach them how to use a computer. Because mom and dad aren't always there, especially when they're doing it in the school building, and then they come home mad because they have all this extra homework because they couldn't finish their classwork because it took them 6 years to type a sentence because they don't know what they're doing. Okay, rant over. This scarf is almost done. Then we're gonna move on over to the bookmark. I have never made this bookmark before, so you and I are going to go on an experience together. New bookmark making journey. Under the stitch. There. And that was actually one more stitch than needed anyway, so that works. Alright, going to slip stitch there. Now we're going to get our 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8 stitches for our wrap around here. Turn the inside out. We're going to do the wrap here. And then secure that into the back of this. Simple slip stitch. For some securing stitches. And then a locking stitch. And the scarf will be done. Finish that off my usual way, so now I gotta use my needle here to lock that in. There we go. Couple weaves since I had to do something different. There we go. And now that scarf is done for our next friend. Yay! Stifling his knees. Hold on. Whew. There we go. Alright. With this little bit of yarn left, I don't think I will have enough to make a full scarf out of that, so I'm going to have to get a new thing of yarn. Alright, so. Now, we are going to explore our new one. We are going to make a bookmark. I'm excited about because, honestly, Hi, Jenny! we boyfriend just posted on the Facebook page that she can't figure out how to chat. So I'm going to have to go give her a lesson then. So you see this, Jenny? Hi. All right. So we're going to use this pretty, pretty blue turquoisey yarn. And I'm going to start on this bookmark. So follow along with me if you're watching and want to make one. So here we go. We are going to... Now this is funny. It starts off with telling me how to do it. Oh, no, there it is. I just missed it. Okay. A chain of 33. That makes so much more sense. So it looked like it was telling me to do some stitches into stitches that didn't exist for the first round. All right. So chain 33. One, two, three. Right, there's 33. And now, maybe I'll go give this to my friend Jenny when I'm done. Alright, it wants us to go into the second one. So we're going to yarn over, insert into that one, yarn over and draw the loop. Okay, insert hook into next chain, yarn over, oh, we're doing this three times, okay, one, we're going into the same stitch, two, three, we're going to pull through all six loops. Alright, I'm going to assume that I did that wrong. So we're going to try that again. Pull that back out. Alright. So I'm going to yarn over, insert into that stitch, draw up a loop. Yep. I've got three loops. Insert into my next chain. Now I'll go to the next chain. And then next chain. Okay. So now I'm going to pull through all of those. And chain one. Next up, we're going to insert into the chain one space, okay, going into there, and then draw with two loops, yep, alright, so far so good, insert hook into the leg of the last stitch, okay, going into here. Okay. Hook into the chain of the last stitch. Oh, that is the chain. I want into the leg, which is going to be this guy. Ugh. Right there. And then into the chain. I should have one, two, three, four. Got that. Still on the right track. Insert into the next chain. Do that two times, but one more chain. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yep, loops. We are going to pull through all of those. Chain one. Okay. Here's the start of it. So this is called a star stitch. And first of all, I should tell you where I got this pattern from. So what we are going to come out with this is from thispixiecreates.com. That's P-I-X-I-E for Pixie. Thispixiecreates.com, and it's the simple Daisy bookmark. So that is where this pattern is coming from. I do not take ownership of this pattern. Alright, and it wants me to do that last set of instructions 15 times to get down the row. So here we go. We're going to come into that. That's center part, and then into the leg, and then into the chain space, and then into the next two chain spaces. All six stitches. I feel like I messed up because that is so tight. Either that or it is stuck on another thread somewhere, which I think is what it is. I think it grabbed something it shouldn't have grabbed, so we're just going to start there. There was no give on that, and that was weird. Into the leg. This guy. That's three. Into the chain, that's four. Into the next chain, and into the next chain, and that makes six. And we'll pull through. There we go. Now it's loose. And there. Oh, this is coming together. Alright, going back in. For one, get into... That's the hardest part, is getting into the leg. Maybe I should loosen my tension up a little bit here. Making it too tight, and thus making it more difficult on myself. Oopsie. Yep, it's grabbing something. There we go. There it goes. I like this blue color. My daughter's favorite color is turquoise. But if anybody thinks that I should give her this bookmark, she has 6 billion bookmarks. Including some that I have made for her. So I am not neglecting her in that area, in the least. My daughter, well, all of my kids really, they love to read. But my daughter is one of those that reads when she's not supposed to be reading. She's supposed to be doing something else, or is reading 16 books at once and goes back and forth between them all the time, and she's just all over the place. Not that I'm complaining. I love that she loves to read. It's just when she asks me to read a story to her and she has me jump right into the middle of a book one night and then in the middle of another book another night, it's confusing for me. Because then I don't know what story I'm reading anymore. Really pretty. Can you see that? Can't get my camera to focus on this. It's still focused on me. It's so fuzzy. clearly this camera does not have an autofocus on it, so I might have to play with some settings, see if I can find one, if it has one at all. Getting there. Almost through. I made that leg really tight again. Loosen up, Katie. Loosen up. Oh, that one was a lot better. That's because I didn't go to the right one. That's why. That's why it was so much easier. Alright, let's try that one again. That one I went kind of wonky on. Alright. Chain space. I seem to have lost my leg on that. What did I do wrong? I don't know. I don't know. I'm gonna have to undo that stitch, figure out what I did wrong. I was doing so well. Alright. Chain space. Leg space. Did I forget to chain on the last one? Is that what it was? I'm not sure. And chain space, and then chain space, and then chain space again. I feel like I did all of that. I don't know how I messed up last time. Alright, so, chain space, leg space. Six. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yep, looks like. And then I just completely flip it off. That works too. Not really. Fold through all of those. Well, whatever it is that I managed to do, I figured it out, I guess. I somehow got my leg space back. But now that leg's really tight. Open it up from the other side. There we go. So this stitch actually takes longer than I thought. Well, maybe it wouldn't if I did it right every time. I've never done this stitch before, so this is new for me. It's pretty. I like it. Apparently, the star stitch is commonly used in blankets. But considering I don't really make blankets all that much, I've made a few of them in my time, but not often. It's not surprising that I've never used it. Our stitches are not a regularly used stitch in Amigurumi. We are on our last one here. We get to go down the other side and finish off this bookmark. You know, I think I figured out what my problem was on that previous weird one. It appears that I did not, I'm guessing at least, that I did not yarn over this thing. Incorporate the tail of that. I did not yarn over when I went into the leg stitch portion. Where do I have 15? I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. I did it right, guys. I did it right. Alright. So now I can move on to the next part. All pictures. Alright, turn your work on it, and do not chain one to start the new row. Okay, not chaining. Instead, go directly into the eye of the stitch. That's going to be this big guy. No, that would be my top stitch. That's what it's going to be. So I'm going to go into that top stitch there. Make sure I'm right. Hold on. Pictures are great when you're a little unsure. Yep. Okay. I got it right. But I want to bring this up so I can work it in. Alright. We'll do it this way. This loose a little bit so I can get around this and work it in. There we go. Not too tight of a space to draw it in there. Alright, we are going to, we went into the eye, we're making two single crochet into the eye of each across. That's easy enough. One. I'm going to assume that that means these teeny tiny ones as well. They kind of get small. Big build up, so I might be wrong in that. Let me double check. Let's see. Should be a total of 30 at the end of row 2. They are going into that one. No, they're not doing the tiny ones. Back it up. Back it up. This once more and do it correctly. That's why I try not to move past an instruction too far until I can really see what I'm doing for that very reason that we just experienced right there. Alright, the tail is worked in, so now we can run down the row here. And wrap this guy up. I keep getting caught on individual threads coming out. It's ever so slightly annoying. Okay, we've reached the end. Thank you. Looks like that. Again, it doesn't focus, so it's hard to see. But that's where it's at. And for the last thing, we want to add a tassel to end the row and finish the bookmark. Slip stitch into the side of the first stitch of row one, fasten off, and weave in the ends. You know how I feel about weaving. I love it so much. I really don't. Two slip stitches. Go across there. Cut that off. And a nice simple bookmark with a pretty, pretty stitch. Yay! Just kind of even all those stitches out. I feel like I went a little crazy right here with something. It's not quite straight. It wants to curl out. Alright, and now for the final bits, it wants to add a tassel. So, let's see. That's something I wasn't prepared for. Hold on. Let's see. Let's go with, I need something to wrap it around. This might work. Handy dandy, a hole puncher. Of course, in my color, because, you know, it's what I do. Alright, we are going to wrap this around. Slip a 5-inch piece of yarn between the cardboard. I don't make a lot of tassels. So, oh, okay. I see. Pictures are worth 1,000 words, y'all. We're going to, it's definitely there. Cut that off so I can use that. And then we're going to wrap, wrap, wrap. Be a short tassel. Okay. Something wider to make a long tassel. And this one's going to be a short tassel. We're going to slip that around. This is convenient though because I have a nice easy place to slide under. Alright. Slide under there. Make two knots. Not one. Not one, but two. Sorry, corny joke. It was there though. Alright. Make two knots with a yarn needle. That's this guy. Insert the yarn tail into the top of the bookmark. Crazy things. That made no sense to me. Cut the yarn on the bottom. Oh, I skipped that step. I moved my... I moved my page down too far, too fast. So we are going to... I was wondering when we cut it. I knew we had to cut it. Alright. It's cut from my short tassel here. That's my yarn, my knot piece. Okay, got that. My knot piece. That's my initial tail piece. And that's my still connected tail piece. Dun 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 dun. With a yarn needle. So this is going to be my tail. I can't wrap the other one. Should it be disconnected? I feel like it should be disconnected at this point, right? Should it be? Inexperience coming in with tassel making here. We are going to do something. We're going to did that. It wants me to wrap another one around the tassel to shape the top. I'm so confused by this. It shouldn't be this difficult, right? Y'all have made tassels before, haven't you? I'm gonna cut like this really, really super duper long tail so that I can then make another piece here. Alright, it wants me to tie this guy around to shape the top. I get that. I understand that part. I get that part. Okay, you're tied. You're wrapped around. It's this whole thing with the yarn needle and wrapping the tail around the top part. I'm trying to understand that. I'm just not getting it. It's not computing. Make my two knots again for that guy. I got that. I got the shape part. Shape is there. It's the other part I'm not quite understanding. With a yarn needle, insert the yarn tail into the top of the bookmark. Just like threading through it, I guess. When you are happy with the length of the tail and tassel, secure it in place with a knot. Weave the remaining yarn tail through the back side of the bookmark and trim the tail, because that's attaching it to the bookmark. Okay, I get that part. What is it wanting me to do? Let's see, we are coming around. I'm assuming that they just want me to attach it. I don't know, that's what I'm going with. I guess it's as good as mine because I don't really fully understand what this is saying. I'm gonna have to play around with this a little bit. For now, I'm gonna do what I can think of to do. I'm going to attach this to the bookmark. This might not be the correct way, but it's the Katie way. That's what's happening right here. It's the Katie way. It will not go into the stitch that I wanted to go to. It keeps going somewhere else. You will go through. Aha, I will. Okay, and then I'm going to bring it back down here so I can get this look that it's giving. I'm assuming it has to be done somehow. I just don't know how. That's the part I don't understand, is the how we get that look thing happening. Next time. next time we come back, I'm going to have learned how to make an appropriate dazzle. And not the Katie way, but the right way. That's what's going to happen. Just telling you now. I'm going to figure it out. I am not a tassel queen, obviously. And that is too short. So I'm going to have to do it the hard way. I ran out of tail. Well, that sounded bad. Not what I meant. Yarn tail. Alright. You are secured in there. So we're going to flip you. And the tassel looks funny because, again, I don't know what I'm doing. All of that can go, and then I'm going to make it all even because that bugs me. And there we go, Katie's makeshift tassel. Oh, I gotta weave this for a second. Almost done. I swear it. To leave this in just a little bit so I can cut it. And it not be noticeable. Cut that off. Oh, nope, so connected. Just kidding. Alright. And we are, don't want the needle. We are done with our bookmark. There we go. It looks funny because it's off the side, but for first time, I don't think it's that bad. It'll get better the more I do. Guaranteed. So, there we have it. We've got a finished Yoda. We've got a finished bookmark. And we've had some fun crocheting. So that about covers it. Alright, I will see you guys next week for more crocheting fun, I guess. Have a happy Thanksgiving if you're in the States and you are seeing this. Enjoy. Spend time with family. Relax. Have some fun. Eat lots of food. And enjoy some football. Cowboys, no less. Always. Alright, have a good one. Bye, everybody.